Well, hello and a very warm welcome, folks, to our coverage of the Puckyverse, Milton Keynes Lightning versus the Peterborough Phantoms. It's Derby Day here in Buckinghamshire, and what a game we have got in store for us here. Let's play some hockey. Puck makes its way now back towards Ben Solder, and how these home fans would love an early goal to just dent the morale of the travelling Phantoms. Puck now makes its way towards Rutkus. He's got Carhammer with him. Rutkus' first time shot is saved by the right boots of Hayden Levine. Opens up the opportunity on the counter now for Luke Ferrara. Luke Ferrara takes the shot, deflected away by Jordan Headley, will make its way all the way into the offensive zone of the Peterborough Phantoms. There'll be a little bit of a battle, a tussle, a melee on the boards here. You can just tell already the energy between both these sides is electric. Here's Dylan Lawrence trying to slice and dice and weave his way through. Comes out to Venus. Oh, Lawrence attempted. A little cheeky one there. Great hustle shown by Gulliver. Lawrence is in. Slides it across to Venus. Excellent save from Hayden Levine. Lightning really applying the pressure here in the early stages. Yet again, Hayden Levine, the Great Wall of Peterborough, standing strong. Now the Phantoms, maybe with an attack of their own. It's the number two, Tom Norton. Excellent checking though from the Lightning. There's a chance here potentially. Gives it to Max Stewart. Deflected. Just out of reach and turned in. Liftoff for the Lightning here on Derby Day. And just listen to that crowd reaction. Well, I spoke about Hayden Levine. Again, this is an excellent first-time save there. A little bit of miscommunication as well between Scott Robson and Hayden Levine. Bit of afters, potential trip there, but the Phantoms are in. Headley, smart save. So much going on in this opening 6 minutes or so. We've still got another couple of periods of play after this. Headley now tested from long range. Another line change as Palmer, Hunt and Thorpe come on for the Peterborough Phantoms. Dylan Lawrence slicing, weaving his way through. Backhand shot saved by Levine. And work to do now for the Phantoms. They are under so much pressure here early on. Tim Wallace will be absolutely delighted by this start. Tricky play. Another couple of changes as Joe Gretton comes on for the Phantoms. Wallace comes on now for the Lightning. Tempers starting to flare ever so slightly. Max Stewart is bursting for the purpose. Here's Jordan County. County across towards Max Stewart. Excellent goaltending yet again by Hayden Levine. Did that excellently against the Wildcats. Myself and Tom on commentary were questioning it at times because the majority of teams are very compact. They almost go into that almost square defence or rectangular defence, and instead Grinnell Park was almost operating like a point guard would in basketball. But yeah, 10 seconds remaining then. Potential final chance here, and it goes in. It's Callum Bouglas. Well, that is just what the doctor ordered as far as the Peterborough Phantoms are concerned. Ed Nagsy was called for the high stick, resulted in the penalty in the first place. And ultimately, it's actually turned in by Cam Huff. And if that is the case, that's his 16th goal of the season. And that will also signal an end to period number one. It's the Puckyverse, Milton Keynes Lightning 1, Peterborough Phantoms 1. King, let's play hockey then in period number 2 here on Super Saturday. And how the Phantoms would love to silence these fans early on in the second period. How the Lightning would love to get an early goal of their own as well. They did so in the first period. Toms Rutkus was the man. He's a man in form, and here he is in possession of the puck. Gives it out towards Martelli. What will Malik do here? Well, he scores an absolute beauty. Malik Martelli continues his streak of scoring when I'm commentating on Lightning TV. And that is a top-notch effort from the Lightning defenceman had time and space down the left-hand side, weighs up his options, takes the shot. And made it 21 assists for the season, Headley yet again. Well, he was defiant there. And that right there illustrates the physical nature of this one. The Finnish magician will be looking to open up this defence. Gives it to Ferrara. Headley was sprawling. It just goes to the left-hand side of the Lightning goaltender's pipe. Here's Buglas again to Ferrara. Great save from Headley. It's really solid defensive play here from the MK Lightning. Potential opportunity here for Ross Venus. Oh, what a short-handed goal was there for the taking, and that is a successful penalty kill from the Lightning. It's all going on here. Some smart defending there from Jordan Spadafore. Means that the Lightning now can produce an attack of their own as Grinnell Park is dispossessed. Duncan Spears, he's got Vence Katonis with him. Stead goes on his own. Headley just about turns it away. Will it be given? Yes, it will. That is the equaliser for the Peterborough Phantoms. It was absolute chaos and carnage in Jordan Headley's crease. It's a darting skate forward by Duncan Spears. It's a good save initially there from the Lightning number one, but the puck eventually is scrambled in. Robson was there. And now the Lightning can clear their lines, potentially go on an attack of their own. Here's Jordan Cowney. Just slides it beyond the right-hand pipe. Victor there. Archie Salisbury now makes the run down the channel. Here's Jordan Cowney trying to pinch the puck off of Hayden Levine, who's unsighted there. Well, you can call it brave goaltending there to come out of the crease. But Jordan Cowney is not a man that you want to give those second opportunities to. And speaking of opportunities, here is Brad Bowering, almost one-on-one. But he's disrupted momentarily by Nags. It'll be turned in by Austin Mitchell-King to make it Peterborough 3. Milson Keynes Lightning 2. Well, it's just excellent play. It's recycling defence into attack. Bowering had so much time and space, almost acres of ice. It's slotted back into the centre. Almost calling the Manuel Neuer of ice hockey. Oh, that's lovely control from Cameron Huff. Jordan Headley, though, with the save. Hunter has his pockets pinched. And now here come the Lightning. Dylan Lawrence slides it across. First time shot from Grinnell Park. Tremendous stop from Hayden Levine on what could have been a thoroughly deserved shorthanded goal. Spadafore gets in there though. Stewart and Lawrence, the other men. Headley, that is outstanding from the Lightning shotstopper. Ferrara now again met by Headley. Takes a few extra seconds off that clock. Here is Cam Huff. Ferrara's there. Huff takes the shot himself. Jordan Headley is having a tremendous game here. Telling you now, folks, if you're watching this along at home, do not go anywhere. This third period is going to be a memorable one. Venus works it away. They've just got to try and get it forward. Norton can't corral it. And that will bring us to an end to a hectic second period. We'll start with a 5-on-3 as referee Jarvie drops the puck. Let's play some hockey. Ferrara wins back the puck. And now the Lightning comes surging forward. Hamill, he's got McEwen and Rutkiss for company. Here is Toms Rutkiss. Back towards Hamill. Wonderful save yet again by Hayden Levine. Somehow manages to snap out the danger. Here is Ross Venus, massive opportunity. Levine yet again, it's deja vu. Lovely puck movement this from the Milton Keynes Lightning. They just need the final finishing product. Here's Dylan Lawrence. Will he take the shot? He will. That is some heroic defending from the Phantoms, who have a massive chance here in the form of Austin Mitchell-King. He's got company in the middle. Mitchell-King again. Jordan Headley, take a bow. Palmer in there as well. Headley somehow keeps that out. And here we go. There's a bit of argy-bargy. Some pulling, some pushing, some shoving. He cannot make his way through the wall of white shirts as Jordan Cowan is slightly sloppy. Now there's a two-on-one opportunity here. Hunt is in the middle. Will he utilise him? No, he won't. Ed Nags, that was exceptional. Jason Earls takes his time to drop the puck out towards Ferrara. Ferrara to Larkin, and Ferrara again. And Headley now, bit of afters, shoves Cameron Huff down. Separation, trying to bring his forwards into the game. He's got Cowney and Lawrence in there as well. Ross Venus, Lawrence attempts to poke it home. Can't quite do so for the time being. Here is Ross Venus though, utilising Jordan Cowney. Will Cowney take the shots? Yes, he will! Colossal from Cowney, magnificent from Milton Keynes, who draw level in spectacular style here at Planet Ice Milton Keynes. I said it would take something special. I said Jordan Cowney would be one of the main men to do it, and he fires it home with complete and utter aplomb past Hayden Levine. Things really heating up here. Here is Martelli, shoveled away by Cowney, put back into the danger zone. Back now with Duncan Spears. He's got Norton with him in the points. How has Headley saved that one? It's kicked away, comes out towards McEwen. Can he put it home? No, he can't. It's bouncing around like a pinball. Hayden Levine ultimately clears his lines as Corey McEwen can't poke home. Ed Nags though gets the puck back, only for a split second though. Now the Lightning will surge forward in the form of Ed Nags. Will he take the shots? Oh, it was a slightly tame effort that. Really does throw a gigantic cat amongst the pigeons. Here's Dylan Lawrence. Oh, it smacks into the face of the Peterborough defender. It's Duncan Spears. He's going to have to come off there. Smacked him straight in the jaw. Here's Lawrence on the rebounds. The net yet again comes off his moorings. What will this crazy encounter dish up? Martelli. Attempted pass towards Carter Hamill. Oh, if he could have scored then, that would have absolutely blown the roof off this place. Now the Lightning driving forward in the shape of Carter Hamill. Here's Hamill, huge chance. Agonisingly wide. And who else but Malik Martelli on the check. Wins it back. Here's Max Stewart dancing into the centre. Well, this is pandemonium now. Is Larkinen unsighted, attempted shovel with the backhand. Less than 2 minutes remaining as Nags and Salem get into it. It's an almighty scrap here, both sides really battling away. Huge chance here for Peterborough. It's deflected eventually off Spadafore. The shot was from Cam Huff. Now Robson back again. Harry Gulliford, you can hear the oohs and ahs of the crowd. Ross Venus down the left-hand side, utilises Venus. Will he be the hero? Ross Venus! No, he won't on that occasion. Venus keeps possession of the puck, though. Little bit of a 180. Well, there's screams of a foul. And there is a delayed penalty. Jarvie's got his hands up. 24 seconds remaining then. Force a pass up towards. I think that's going to be that. It will be that. That is the end of regulation. Here we go then, 5 minutes to try and separate these two sides. Who will get that golden goal? Venus, Lawrence, Cowney and Wallace. The unit here, can Tim Wallace finish it nice and early? What an incredible clash of the Titans this has been. So much at stake for both of these teams when it comes to the league, when it comes to the cup, when it comes to bragging rights. There's nothing like a Derby Day victory. Here is Luke Ferrara now, under tremendous pressure by Gulliver. Larkinen back towards Ferrara. Will Ferrara take the shot? He does. It's deflected though by Gulliver. Back with Larkinen. Happy to just provide a little bit of respite. Here is Luke Ferrara. Dishes it back towards Larkinen. Back to Ferrara. And that will be that. Luke Ferrara, the Phantoms captain. And unsurprisingly, I'd also give it to this man. It is Hayden Levine. Absolutely solid as a rock. He's been a fantastic addition into this Phantoms lineup. You think back to last season when this club won in the playoffs. They had Jordan Maher. He's now gone to the Solway Sharks. Hayden Levine really has stood up to the plate. Where's Jordan Headley? Fair enough. Both goaltenders absolutely superb this evening. So now we'll take the next few moments here on Remembrance Weekends to remember those who have paid the ultimate sacrifice to our country. So we here on Lightning TV will go quiet for the next few moments as we'll have the last post, our moment silence, and then we'll have the national anthem.
Tonight.